guys. So pardon the hair, I'm about to go work out. But before I do, I had something I wanted to discuss, something that was on my mind for a little bit. And that was the fact that, like, I was watching this movie on Netflix and it was really good. And I happened to realize that the movie company that released it was A24. And A24 seems to release really good movies such as these. So they've released movies like It Follows, Midsummer, also The Witch as well. So they've released some really good movies in the past. And so they just recently released The Killing of Sacred Deer, The Killing of the Sacred Deer. And I watched it on Netflix the other day and it was really good. Their content, A24 produces content that's like no one else will touch. They push the boundaries and I really love that about A24, and I wanted to just, you know, recognize, I like recognizing such content such as that. That's really cool. They push the boundaries on different content that no one else would want to talk about or wouldn't even think to talk about. It's just so bizarre. And so when I saw The Killing of a Sacred Deer, it was just really good, but mainly the content is just so bizarre. I loved it. Loved it. So highly recommend checking that out on Netflix. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and work out and I'll see you later. Bye. Hey guys, so I just finished working out, but I wanted to show you a little bit of what I use for my hair, which is pretty ironic because since I just finished working out, my hair looks like a mess, but that's what makes this video perfect, right? So what I use for my conditioner is the Diva Curl One Condition Decadence line. It's this huge bottle I'm using, so it's like 32-ounce bottle, and I'm like almost done with it. That's how much I use it, just simply because it works. And I use that once a week, and every other month I'll go ahead and clean my hair with this, with their shampoo, No Poo Decadence line as well. This is a small bottle, just simply because I don't use it very often, once every other month. But yeah, I love this Diva Curl line simply because, like, all you need is that, a little bit of that, and just water. That's all you really need is water. I used to use Shea Moisture, and I loved them simply because, like, I was just, like, so loyal to them. They're such a good brand, but, like, it just didn't get my hair, like, the way I wanted it to. But the conditioner did, for the Diva Curl did, anyway. So I use that, and typically that bottle is like $50 at Ulta, but now, and in the context, I'm gonna get it from Amazon because it's like $30, I found out. So I'm gonna get it from Amazon just simply because of that, that it's way cheaper on there than on Ulta. So that's where I'm gonna get some more at, but that's what I use for my hair. Just thought I'd share that tidbit. I'm gonna go ahead and get cleaned up and eat some breakfast, and I'll see you later. All right, bye. Hey guys, so I am going to go ahead and give you a bookshelf tour. So we're gonna start with the top here. So I have my CDs over on this side. We'll talk about that another time. But here are my books on this shelf. I would have to say for this shelf, my favorite book would have to be, that I've read thus far, would be Tumbleweeds by Lila Michon. I believe that's how you pronounce her name. Lovely author, lovely book, I loved that. Down to this next shelf, these are my books here. My poetry section, it starts from here onward, poetry and anything about poetry or writing. I would have to say my favorite book thus far that I've read, I really like Too Much and Not the Mood by Durga Chubose. Oh my goodness, loved that book. Next down, I have a whole series of The Babysitter's Club. I can't seem to get rid of those just because that's my childhood, so that's a whole series right there. Let me see, is there any favorites? Oh, I really loved Virgin by Radhika Sangani. That book was super good. Down here on this level are my books here. Is there any books? This is my absolute all-time favorite book right here. Harriet Beecher Stowe, Connecticut Girl. Love, love the aesthetic of that book. And down here at the bottom are some more books. Let's get this in focus. There we go. Let's see, I'm trying to think, is there any books on here that really stands out to me? Oh, I loved this book here. Love, Lust, and Faking It by Jenny McCarthy. That is really good. Loved that. And then we're gonna swing on over here to this bookshelf as well. So I have like all my classics over here. I would have to say the one that really stands out is A Child Called It by Dave Peltzer. Oh my God, I cried every other page from that book. I recommend it and then I don't. and then last but not least, we have this bookshelf area here. Some of these books are Robert's, so those are his Harry Potter books. And then the books end right about here. Then I have my finished journals and diaries and calendars over there. I guess the one book I really love from this section was Old Songs in a New Cafe by Robert James Waller. He's the author who wrote Bridges of Madison County. That was a really thoroughly good book. All right, guys, I'm going to jet on out, but I will see you another time. All right, bye. Hey guys, I thought I'd give you a quick tour of my old poetry binder that I have so with me. I can't show you my new one because the poems in there are being submitted right now, but I can at least show you my old one that I haven't touched nor am submitting anytime soon. So here we go. So you open it up, I have like some old poetry contests I had once submitted years ago. These are the pieces that like I was in the middle of like editing during some time ago. I have some extra like folder dividers, and then we get into the whole binder part. So we have chapter one, my poem life. So this usually was poetry I wrote, I guess about poetry, but just about basically anything that came to mind. Next up, I have chapter two, my songs. Like I thought, well, you know, if I write poetry, I can write songs. That was an awkward little period I had because I realized, I don't think I'm gonna be doing that such thing. So. Those were my songs I had. And then next section I have is chapter three, my inspired poems. So these are poems that are like actually not made by me, but by actual people who had written those, but they have inspired me somehow. And then I have, I guess this is chapter four. Yeah, chapter four, love poems. Self-explanatory. These are all love poems I had written once upon a time. And then let's see here, chapter five, life poems. I wrote a lot about life, just things that just came into my mind during that time. And then nature, chapter six. I like this section. I write a lot about nature, so I would write pieces on there. And then chapter seven was comedy. So any poems that I thought would be kind of like a little chuckle, a little funny, I wrote those as well. That had like a little funny punchline at the end or something. So we have that. And then I guess these are some things like maybe still in the process of being edited, or you know, just extra paper I had, something that I wrote about. So yeah, and this is a big binder. So let's see here. And this poem right here, The Sun and the Moon, I love this poem. So I ended up having that be the cover photo, if you will, of my whole poetry binder. So. That is it. That is my poetry binder.
from back in the day.
And with that, I will see you another time. All right, bye. Okay, so I have a little rant as of right now. So I was reading, and right now I'm currently reading like this anthology of short stories, but the genre is thriller. And one thing I happen to notice is that I just finished reading this one short story, and it aggravated me because it was really long. It was a really long short story, and I'm reading it, and I'm like, okay, so when's the payoff? Where, hopefully this is worth it. And the short story actually wasn't worth it. Like, it ended, and after like, how many pages was it? It was like 30 plus pages, like 34 pages, something like that. And like, I read it, and at the end I was just like, okay, like why did it end like this? It wasn't even scary. It was set back in like the 1700s, so like, and it had like Benjamin Franklin in it, James Adams, and you know, everybody like that. But I was like reading it, and I'm like, okay, where's the punchline here? Because when I'm reading a thriller story, that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the punchline. There was no punchline, and I'm just like, oh my god. It was like, I was just so aggravated, and I'm starting to notice that's like a pet peeve of mine. Like, I'm reading a thriller, I'm expecting to be thrilled, and the whole time Benjamin Franklin is just playing this game of, you know, like, what is this riddle about? And it was just like, oh my god, like, why? This isn't even scary at all. I was just so frustrated. So I read that short story, and at the end I felt like chucking the book across the room, because I was like, oh my god, I just wasted my time. But anyway, this is so stupid. But anyway, that is my rant for the day. I will see you later. Bye. Hey guys, so I am back. I just wanted to say a few words real quick. And that is the fact that just over the weekend, because today's Sunday, right? So over the weekend, I think it was like Friday, Harkins had went on ahead and announced that they were going to let us have like bags of popcorn that they have already popped and everything. And they had slight like nachos and stuff there as well. So me and Robert were like, heck yeah, we're gonna go. So we went, and great service. Everybody was wearing their masks and gloves, loved it. And so we bought the popcorn, but along with it, they had these bad boys right here. And you know, I was like looking at Robert like, should we get it? And he was like, we should. I mean, it was only $2. So we were like, okay, I'll get it. And so we ended up getting it, and that night we went on ahead and had like a movie night, and we watched the Killing of the Sacred Deer was one of the movies we watched. And you know, as we were eating the popcorn, actually Robert had poured some of that butter flavoring oil on top of the popcorn that we had bought, and I kid you not, it was really good. Like, really good. The popcorn tasted exactly like as if we were actually at the movie theater, which is something I personally miss since, you know, this whole virus thing went down. So I was sitting there asking Robert, oh my gosh, like, why are they giving us this? And it was only $2. And Robert was like, he brought up a good point. He was like, you know, they probably just have all that oil just sitting there, so they might as well just go ahead and sell it. And I was like, yeah, you know what, you've got a point there. So, but man, what a steal. I mean, this bad boy is only like $2, and like, it made my night. That thing was amazing with the popcorn. So yeah, thank you Harkins for that. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and relax for the night, eat my blueberries, but I will see you all tomorrow morning. All right, bye.